Everyone needs Alex here, the guy who spent 3 hours to automate a simple 5-minute task so you don't have to. Today, I'll show you how to bulletproof your code using GitHub Actions CI in just 5 minutes. And not those 5-minute tutorials that really takes 25 minutes. CI/CD is your code's autopilot, and this is why it's not negotiable in 2025. Every commit becomes a verified checkpoint. You'll kill, but works in my computer. And merge pull requests without anxiety. In a nutshell, CI is a practice of using automation to enable teams to merge code changes into a shared repository. Each commit or pull request triggers an automatic workflow on a CI server that runs a series of tests to make sure that this commit is safe to merge in the main branch. A good CI process relies on a good set of tests, because a well-tested application prevents breaking changes, speeds up the development cycle by allowing developers to merge with confidence. By automating this test, teams can move faster, ship better code, and maintain a quality code base over time. Now that we understand why continuous integration is so important, let's see how to set up a CI pipeline using GitHub Action. So, open your favorite code editor, create your repository, and under the directory GitHub's workflow, create a file called ci.yaml. Drop this CI blueprint. This line is your automation trigger. It's used from GitHub to know when specific events occur. This is a basic Node.js setup, but with a little improvement, npm caching. But how it works? GitHub stores node modules after the first run, so it's ready to reinstall from the cache the second time, so it translates in less downloading. But what if the cache gets corrupted? We can add a cache fallback, like this one. Why npm CI instead of npm install? There are three principal reasons. Consistency matches package lock exactly. Safety deletes node modules before installing. And speed skips dependency resolution. So now, if we push our code to GitHub, GitHub spins up a fresh Ubuntu virtual machine, clones our repo, reuse the cache but only if it is available, and as the last step, runs test. In this tutorial, we focused poorly on a CI pipeline because we didn't touch the deployment part, because it depends specifically on your environment and your infrastructure. But let me know in the comments if you want another video that covers the continuous delivery part using ArgoCD. Out of there are a lot of tools when we talk about continuous integration, like Jenkins, CircleCI, Travis, and so on. They are great, but this is why GitHub Action is better. Native integration without any third complexity, you are able to run your pipeline with only GitHub. Over 5,000 pre-built actions for tools like Slack, AWS, Docker, and so on. And you have 2,000 free monthly Linux that save your code. When you more file, no DevOps circus, total control. In this quick tutorial, you have just built a modern CI that actually works. No fluff, no legacy code. Now it's your turn. Which tools or topics should I cover next? Do you have any crazy pipeline ideas? If you have any other question, leave a comment, smash a like, subscribe, and see you in the next video.